So you've got your flower colors or your mouse coat colors or whatever, and you're working your Punnett square and you get it. Big A is dominant over little a, but why? Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about why some alleles are dominant and some are recessive. Let's start with an example, and we're going to use berry color. And in this system, berry color is controlled by a single gene. And we've got two phenotypes, blue and white berries. Now, if we take a true breeding blue plant and cross it to a true breeding white plant, all of the F1 have blue berries. And so from that, we can conclude that blue is dominant over white. So we'll call the blue allele big B and the white allele little b. But what's going on here? Why is blue dominant and white is recessive? Well, simply, it's just because having one copy of the big B blue allele is enough to give us the full blue phenotype. Remember, genes are regions of DNA that are transcribed into RNA. And alleles are different versions of a gene, different DNA sequences. So what we're calling the big B allele is transcribed into mRNA, and that mRNA is used to produce a protein that makes blue pigment. The allele that we call little b, the white allele, has a different DNA sequence. It's transcribed into an mRNA with a different sequence, which produces a protein with a different sequence that doesn't produce blue pigment. In the big B genotype, we've got two alleles that lead to pigment production. And in the little b genotype, we've got two alleles that don't. What about the heterozygote? What happens when we have a big B and a little b allele? Are we gonna see pigment production? Well, here, yeah, we are. We see that big B blue phenotype, even though we still have the little b white allele present. The big B allele masks the presence of the little b allele. Often, recessive alleles produce defective or broken products, and that's what you're seeing here. A protein that doesn't do what it's supposed to do. It doesn't do much of anything in this example. But in this case, our heterozygote has a functioning allele that's able to make up for that deficiency. So in this scenario, our functional pigment-making allele, blue, is the dominant one. Is having one copy of the dominant allele always enough to give us that dominant phenotype? Well, no, but that takes us into some scenarios where we don't have complete dominance. In the berry example that we just looked at, big B was completely dominant over little b. This meant that our heterozygote has the same blue phenotype as the homozygous dominant genotype. But what if that single big B allele in the heterozygote didn't produce enough gene product to make enough blue pigment to give us the blue phenotype? It makes enough that we still see blue, but not that nice dark blue of the big B genotype. This would be incomplete dominance. And with incomplete dominance, the phenotype of the heterozygote is more of a blend between the two homozygotes, or like a diluted version of the dominant phenotype. So we've got a third phenotype, sort of a light blue color here. If our two alleles were codominant, you'd see both blue and white in the phenotype of the heterozygote. Some patches of berry would be white, some patches of berry would be blue. Notice that the phenotypes of the homozygous genotypes don't change here. Big B is always blue, and little b is always white. The difference is in the heterozygote, where we have the products of two different alleles present. The type of dominance that we've got is a reflection of how those products combine to produce a phenotype. The phenotype is a reflection of what's happening at the molecular level. Different alleles function and their products interact in different ways. And while it's common for alleles that produce broken or defective products to be recessive, that's not always the case. A broken allele can be dominant sometimes. Imagine a scenario where a broken protein interferes with a functional one, preventing it from doing its job. Or a case where a broken allele produces a product that has a new function, or that functions in the wrong place or at the wrong time. These could be dominant effects. Whether an allele is dominant or recessive is determined by how that allele functions in combination with another allele and how that impacts the phenotype. So drop me a like if you learned something about dominance. Check out my website for tutoring resources, and I'll see you next time. Bye.